friends, let us learn today's topic, mass percentage, empirical formula and limiting reagent from some basic concepts of chemistry. See, mass percentage, it's very simple. Mass of the element present in a compound. See, I'll give one example. You are having 5 subjects, physics, chemistry, math, computer science and English. In that overall percentage, 98% you imagine. In that physics, how much? Chemistry, how much? Math, how much? Computer science, how much? And English, how much? So each one having the proper percentage. Then you will go for that overall percentage. The same way here, what is that? Compound, overall compound in that. What are the elements are present in the compound? In that each percentage, how much it is. So that is the way. Now come to this point. Now percentage composition. A compound is a relative measure of the mass of each different element in the compound. Right? Now let us identify how do we calculate it. In this topic especially, all the concepts will be available and then related problems. Calculation parts also available, and it will be very interesting and easy if you know the concept very well and formulas. Right, now calculate the mass percentage composition of a compound. First and foremost, calculate the molar mass of the compound. Right, second one, calculate the total mass of each element present in the formula of the compound. The last one, calculate the percentage composition. Okay, now here percentage by mass of the element. Now for example, imagine sodium chloride. In that percentage by mass of the element is equal to total mass of the element present divided by molar mass of the element. So in the into 100. So percentage composition, no. So in this way you have to calculate it. See, I'll give one example. In that way, let us calculate it. Hope you got an idea how to calculate it. Okay, now let us go for the sums to identify this problem, how to solve the problem. Yes? Now let us discuss the percentage composition through some related sums so that we will come to know the clarity of the concept. Calculate the percent by mass of sodium and chlorine in sodium chloride. This is very simple and easy question. Come on, let us discuss this question. First and foremost, let us find out the molecular mass of sodium chloride. So, molecular mass of sodium chloride. How much it is? Sodium, it is 23 plus chlorine. 35.5. So altogether it is 58.5 gram per mole. Right, now sodium, how much is present in sodium chloride? So mass percentage by mass of sodium in sodium chloride, how much it will be? Let us discuss about this. So mass of sodium, that is 23, divided by total molecular mass of sodium chloride, how much? 58.5 into 100. So how much? By the time, let us find out the chlorine also. The same way, percentage by mass of chlorine in sodium chloride. So here what it is, 35.5. By the time I think you got the answer, divided by 58.5 into 100. I think you got the answer. Okay, now the first one, when you calculate this, 39.32 percentage you will get because into 100. The same way, this is 60.68. percentage you will get. When you add this together, you have to get 100. Just notice that this is the way, simple way you can recheck the answer whether it is correct or not. So when you add these two, you will get 100 percentage. Right? So that means sodium in sodium chloride, how much percentage it is present in sodium chloride? 39.32 percentage. The same way, Chlorine in sodium chloride, how much? 60.68% present. Okay, now let us discuss some more questions related to this point, right? Now let us discuss another one more question. Calculate the percentage by mass of each element present in Na2SO4, sodium sulfate. Let us discuss first and foremost molecular mass of sodium sulfate. Molecular mass of sodium Na2SO4. How much it is? Actually, here 2 sodium, right? So 2 into 23 plus 32.06 plus here oxygen 4 into 16. So altogether you will get 142.06 gram per mole. Right? Okay, now let us discuss each element, how much percentage present in sodium sulfate. So percentage by mass of sodium in Na2SO4, how much you will get it? So 23 into 2, it is 46 divided by 142.06 into 100. How much by the time you will come to know? Then second one, percentage by mass of sulfur in Na2SO4. How much contribution from each element? That is the way. So here 32.06 divided by 142.06. So how much you will get it into 100? Sorry, into 100. Then the last one, percentage by mass of oxygen in Na2SO4. So how much you will get it here? 4 into 16, right? So 64 divided by 142.06 into 100. So how much you will get it? First one, I think you got the answer. Come on, let us check it. The first answer, it will be 32.38%. Is it correct? Did you check the answer? Yes, the second one, you will get 22.57% everything. Then the last one here, 45.05%. So all together, if you add, you will get 100%. Right? Hope you got a clear idea how to calculate the percentage composition. Suppose if you are getting such kind of thing, I hope you will do it. And okay, can test your own self. Test yourself question. CaCO3. How can you calculate the mass percentage? Okay, I think you will do this one. It's very simple and easy one. Okay, come on. Let us go for the empirical formula, which is very, very important. 3-mark question. This is also 3-mark question, but it's very simple, easy one. Empirical formula, it's very, very important. Let us go for the empirical formula. How to solve? What do you mean by empirical formula? Let us go and find out. The next one, empirical formula. This is one step higher in mass percentage composition. Okay, now let us come to that idea about that empirical formula. Empirical formula, it's a simplest whole number of each of the element present in a compound. Now, for example, carbon 6, hydrogen 6, that is benzene. So, what is the empirical formula of benzene? Means carbon and hydrogen, CH only. So, 1:1. So, simplest whole number ratio of the element present in a compound. So, that is called empirical formula. Come on, let us identify. An empirical formula gives the simplest whole number ratio of atoms of different elements present in a compound. I hope you got a clear idea. Yes, molecular formula shows the exact number of atoms of different types present in a molecule of a compound. Now we have to consider both empirical formula and molecular formula. Now, why do we go for empirical formula and molecular formula hand in hand? The empirical formula and molecular formula, now for example, how to calculate it? Benzene C6H6, it's a molecular formula. From that only empirical formula comes, that is simplest whole number ratio carbon S to hydrogen, that means C1H1. So that is the simplest whole number. That is what I just to bring that one small example. If carbon and hydrogen present in a compound and the ratio of 1:2, the empirical formula of the compound is CH2. I just to put that example. Even the same way, C6H6, this is the benzene molecular formula. What is the empirical formula? What is the empirical formula of benzene? Carbon and hydrogen. What is the simplest ratio, whole number ratio? It is 1:1. So in that way, you can calculate it. Okay, now how do we calculate it? Now, the empirical formula mass of the compound is CH2. So empirical formula, it's nothing. Simplest whole number ratio of the each atom present in a compound. Now, this is the empirical formula. This 1:2, it's an empirical formula ratio. So, carbon, hydrogen, carbon 1, hydrogen 2. So, in this, mass of the empirical formula, so that is what it is, CH2, that is 1:2. So, carbon atomic mass 12, hydrogen atomic mass 1. How many are there? Here 2, so 1:2. So, all together you are getting 14 gram per mole. So, this is 14 gram per mole, only the empirical formula, simplest whole number ratio of the compound. That is only. Now, you have to find out the molecular mass. This is like Xerox, you have to find out the original in that way. So, this is a molecular mass, molar mass of the compound. So, how to identify N into empirical formula? What do you mean by N? N, it is the ratio of molar mass and empirical formula mass. So, molar mass and empirical formula mass. So, how to identify N? N, it is the ratio of molar mass and empirical formula mass. So, molar mass divided by empirical mass. That's all. Okay, now as we see some related sums on this concept, we will come to know the clear clarity about that. Right? Let us go for that. Some sums related to this topic. Let us go and analyze this sum. A compound on analysis found to contain following percentage composition: sodium, carbon, and oxygen. Sodium 43.4%, carbon 11.4%, and oxygen 45.3%. Determine the empirical formula and molecular mass. Okay, now given relative molecular mass of the compound 106 gram per mole. In this question, they have provided the molecular mass. You have to find out the empirical formula as well as molecular formula. Okay, in that stepwise we have to go. So first and foremost, they have provided percentage composition. Each element present in that compound, that percentage composition they have provided. So atomic mass we know. Okay, so stepwise if we go, no, easily we can solve this sum. Okay, let us go one by one. Elements. Second one, percentage composition. Composition of the elements, right? Next one, atomic mass of each element. Atomic mass of each element. Okay, now so next one here, relative number of moles. Next one, simplest molar ratio. Simplest molar ratio. Then finally, simplest whole number ratio. Simplest whole number ratio. Right? Okay, now let us identify each and everything. What are the elements are present? Sodium, carbon and oxygen. These are the three points they have provided, right? Okay, now sodium composition, what it is? 43.4% and carbon 11.4% and oxygen 45.3%. In that atomic mass of sodium, it is 23 and carbon it's 12, oxygen 16. And the relative number of moles. Number of moles is what it is, given mass by here atomic mass. So here given mass, what it is, percentage only, we can take it as a given mass. So 43.4 divided by 23. And the same way here, 11.4 divided by 12. And here 45.3 divided by 16. Okay, now what is the answer? Get the answer for sodium 1.89. For carbon, you will get 0.95. And for oxygen, you will get 2.83. Please check it whether the answers are correct. Yes, now we have to find out the simplest molar ratio. What is the simplest molar ratio? This is the simplest molar ratio, which is the least molar ratio. Okay, so 1.89 divided by 0.95. And the same way, 0.95 divided by 0.95. And the last one, 2.83 divided by 0.95. So what is the answer you will get it? So you will get around 2.10 something you will get it. Here 1. And here what you will get it? 3.0 something you will get it. Yes. So now simplest whole number ratio. This is the whole number you have to convert. So 2.10 make us 2 only. And then 1, exactly 1. And 3.0 something you are getting means here you will get 3. So now you have to find out that this is the simplest whole number ratio. Simplest whole number ratio, it is nothing. EM, what it is EM? Empirical formula. So 2, 1 and 3. So sodium, it is 2, Na2. Carbon, 1 and oxygen, 3, Na2CO3. Okay, now let us identify the molecular mass of that simplest whole number ratio, that is empirical formula mass. Then we'll go for molecular mass. So how to identify molecular mass? N into empirical formula. So this is the ratio of the empirical formula and molecular formula. Yes, let us identify. Hope you're clear with it. Let us solve some more steps over here. We have to find out the empirical formula. Empirical formula. What is it, empirical formula? Na2CO3. And mass of the empirical formula. So what is it, mass of the empirical formula? So 2 into 23 plus 1 into 12 plus 3 into 16. So all together you will get what it is? 106 unit. Right. Now here N equal to what it is? Molecular mass. Divided by empirical mass. Empirical mass, it is the simplest whole number ratio. Right. Now here molecular mass, they have provided 106. Let us identify N. 106, it is a molecular mass. Now we have to find out here also 106. Right. So here N equal to the ratio of molecular mass and empirical mass, it is 1. So molecular mass equal to N into empirical mass. So empirical formula. So that is what it is. 1 into 106. That is 1 into Na2CO3. Right? Only one. Hope you're clear with it. So what is the empirical formula and molecular formula? Empirical formula also same. Molecular mass formula also same. Why? Because it is N equal to 1. That is the main criteria. If N it is 1, it is same. If it is N it is 2, 3 means, then it will be double. I hope you are clear with this sum. Okay, some more sums. Let us find out which is important sum. Let us find out, because this is 3 mark question. Easily you can identify if you go stepwise. Now let us solve this sum. Find out the empirical formula and molecular formula of the compound, which contains 51.28%, 9.40%, 27.35% and 11.97% of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen respectively. Molar mass of the compound 234 gram per mole. They have given the molecular mass. Now we have to find out the empirical formula, molecular formula. Yes. Now let us consider the same way elements and percentage composition. Next one, atomic mass. This step, actually, it will be easy to recognize the answer correctly, right? Now, next one, relative number of moles. Relative number of moles, right? Now, the next one here, molar ratio, simplest molar ratio, which is the simplest number, least number, that is simplest molar ratio. Ratio. Then the last one here, simplest whole number. Simplest whole number. Actually, this column wise, no, it will be easy to understand for us. Okay, now first one, elements. What are the elements are present? Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen. And percentage composition they have provided respectively. Here 51.28%, 9.40%, 27.35%, and the last one 11.97%. Right? Now, here atomic mass of carbon 12, hydrogen 1. And oxygen 16. Of course, nitrogen 14. Now, number of moles. Given mass by atomic mass here. Relative number of moles. So, given mass, let us take it as a percentage composition only. So, 51. 51.28 divided by 12. By the time, I think you will calculate it. 9.40 divided by 1. And 27. 0.35 divided by 16, and the last one 11.97 divided by 14. I hope you got an idea. What is the answer here? At 4.27, here 9.40, the same, and here 1.71, and here 0.86. You are getting such answer. Now, simplest molar ratio. So, which is the simplest, very least number? Okay, the here 0.86 is the least number. So, 4.27 divided by 0.86. The same way, 9.40 divided by 0.86. Then the next one, 1.71 divided by 0.86. 86, right? Then the last one, the same, 0.86 divided by 0.86. So you will get one only here. here you will get what it is 2, and here you will get around 11, here you will get 5. Now simplest whole number 5 11 2 1. Okay, now carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen. Carbon 5 is, this is the simplest whole number, right? So this is the molar ratio. So this is simplest whole number. So 5 is to 11 and 2 and 1. So now you have to find out the empirical formula mass. So empirical formula mass, if you find molecular mass, already they have provided empirical mass. If you are finding n, you will get it. So n equal to molecular mass by empirical mass. So you will find out that n. So n into empirical mass, you will get that molecular mass. Whether it is correct or not, we will check it. Okay, now carbon 12 into 5 plus 11 into 1 plus oxygen 16 into 2 plus nitrogen 1 into 14. So all together you will get 117 gram per mole. So this is what it is, empirical formula mass, right? Got it? Now let us identify that what it is, molecular mass of the compound. I'll grab this. Now empirical mass, what it is? Empirical mass. Empirical formula, what it is? That is 117 gram per mole. Empirical formula you know very well, right? Empirical formula, what it is? Carbon 5, hydrogen 11, oxygen 2, nitrogen 1, right? Now this is the empirical formula mass. Now n, you have to find out n. It is what it is, ratio of molecular mass and empirical mass, right? Molecular mass divided by empirical mass. Okay, so molecular mass 234, right? So 234 gram per mole, and empirical mass 117 gram per mole. So altogether you are getting 2. So molecular mass equal to molecular mass equal to n into empirical mass, empirical formula. Okay, mass, no, empirical formula. Here molecular formula mass, right? So empirical formula mass, right? So here n equal to 2, no? So 2 into carbon 5, hydrogen 11, oxygen 2, nitrogen 1. So you will get what it is, carbon 10, hydrogen 22, oxygen 4, nitrogen 2. So all together you are getting that for molecular mass of that compound 234 gram per mole. If you want, you can check with the C10, H22, O4 and N2. Hope you're clear with this, all these points. Is it visible? Now let us identify the limiting reagent. Limiting reagent, it is nothing completely consumed during the reaction. The reactant which is completely consumed, so that is called a limiting reagent, which is excess leftover, that reactant which is called excess reagent. Now come to this point, The reactant which is completely consumed is called a limiting reagent. The reactant which is not completely consumed, left over at the end of the reaction, it's called excess reagent. Okay, now let us solve related sum. 30 grams of magnesium and 30 grams of oxygen reacted. Calculate the composition of the residual mixture, which is the limiting reagent of the solution. Okay, now let us identify this. First one, let us write that equation. Mg plus O2, you are getting MgO, that is half O2. Okay, now 1 mole of magnesium and half mole of oxygen combined together, you are getting magnesium oxide. Okay, generally here 24 gram of magnesium reacts with the 16 gram of oxygen, you are getting 40 grams of magnesium oxide. But here they told, here 30 grams of magnesium and 30 grams of oxygen. So, 24 grams of magnesium produce 40 grams of magnesium oxide. Therefore, 30 grams of magnesium can provide how much magnesium oxide? Okay, now let us discuss with that. So, limiting reagent. Limiting reagent. 24 gram of magnesium can provide 40 grams of magnesium oxide, right? Therefore, 30 grams of magnesium, here they have provided 30 grams of magnesium. How much magnesium it can produce? So, cross multiplication. So, when you are going in that way, 30 into 40 divided by 24, what is the answer? You will get it around 50 grams of magnesium oxide. It can produce 30 grams of magnesium can produce 50 grams of magnesium oxide. Now, this is the first point. Now, second point, oxygen. Oxygen also 30. Now, so second one, 24 grams of magnesium require 16 grams of oxygen. Oxygen. Therefore, 30 grams of magnesium. How much oxygen required? Here also cross multiplication. So, 30 into 16 divided by 24. So, you will get around 20. Right. So, 20 gram of oxygen. Oxygen required. So, the residual form. The residual form, what it is? Magnesium oxide. How much it has produced? 30 grams of magnesium can produce how much? It is 50 grams of magnesium oxide, right? Now, oxygen. Oxygen actually 30 grams it is there. So, in that, how much it has required? 20 grams only. So, 30 grams minus 20 grams. What we received, it is 20 grams, right? So, which, how much it is left over oxygen? Oxygen, it is 10 grams which is left over. So, that means, which is the limiting reagent? Which is the limiting reagent? It is magnesium is the limiting reagent. Magnesium is the limiting reagent. Limiting reagent is equal to magnesium. Hope you are clear with this sum. Okay, now, in our next session, we'll go some more important and interesting questions. I hope you are clear with that mass percentage composition, empirical formula and a limiting reagent. Let us watch in our next session some more important and interesting questions. Thank you for watching.